हेलो एवरीवन, आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड डूइंग वेल एट योर होम। वेल स्टूडेंट, दिस इज़ द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ द वीडियो। फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द वीडियो इज़ ऑलरेडी पोस्टेड ऑन आवर स्कूल यूट्यूब चैनल। द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर, एज आई टोल्ड यू इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर ओनली, 100 ड्रेसेस, द फिफ्थ चैप्टर फ्रॉम योर फर्स्ट फ्लाइट बुक। वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग चैप्टर। वी हैव डन ऑलमोस्ट 1.5 पेज ऑफ द बुक। In that, we have seen that the main leading character of this story is Vanra, who migrated from Poles. So you can say that. But when she attended the school, she was quite a shy girl. She was sitting at the corner, not involving much of the school activity. Even the school student also do not like to interact with her at all. She could be seen only while she came into the school in the morning hour and while going. Others also used to make fun of her. So two of her best friend, okay, they also used to make fun of her. But their intentions were not like that, ki they really want to hurt her. But they just wanted to make Peggy and Maddie, both are the friends, best friend. They always used to wait for her, even if they were getting late. So this is what we have done in the previous lecture. Now today we are going to start with page number 65. Let us start. Vanda Petronsky. Most of the children in room 13 don't have name like that. This is like uncommon name, you can say that. This is not a common name generally people have. They had names easy to say that you can easily speak out, like Thomas, Smith, Alan. There was one boy named Bounce, Willie Bounce, and people thought that was very funny, but not funny in the same way that Petronsky was. Like, one boy was there whose name was Willie Bounce. People used to think that name was also quite funny. So even though that name was not quite so much funny, but even normal name was also looking like quite funny. And this name Vanda Petronsky, this is quite, you can say that, unimaginable name at the age of 13. Student have never heard anything like that. Vanda did not have any friends. She came to school alone and went home alone. She always wore a faded blue dress that did not hang right. It was clean, but it looked as though it had never been ironed properly. Although it was clean, but it was certainly due to the stitches, we can clearly see that this has never been ironed. Now, she did not have any friends, but a lot of girls talked to her. What do you mean by that? Like, she did not have any friend, then to a lot of girls used to talk to her just to make fun. Sometimes they surround her in the schoolyard as she stood watching the little girl play hopscotch on the worn hard ground. When she used to see other girls, so other classmates used to surround her, like what she is doing. That was, you can say that she was getting attention in an uncommon way that generally people do not like. Vanda, Peggy would say in a most, you can say that, cartoon like making fun of, as though she were talking to Miss Mason. Vanda, she would say, giving one of her friends a nudge, tell us, how many dresses did you say you had hanging up in your drawer? Like, please tell us how many dresses you are having at your home that you already told us. Tell others also. So what Vanda would reply? 100, Vanda would say. 100? Exclaimed all the little girls incredulously. Means, what do you mean by incredulously? Which means that showing unwillingness to believe, like surprise, you can say that. Incredulously matlab surprise. They were all surprised. 100 dresses? And little ones once would stop playing hopscotch and listen. Those who were playing the hopscotch, they also would stop and come near to her and start listening to her. Yeah, 100 all lined up in the wardrobe, said Vanda. Then her thin lips drew together in silence. As we have already seen that Vanda never used to speak a lot. Okay, so what are they like? Means, how are they, in which, like they are modern dresses or they are like frocks and all that. all silk, I bet, said Peggy. What Peggy said? They must be of silk. Yeah, all silk and all colors. Velvet too. Velvet is also there. Yeah, velvet too. 100 dresses, Wanda would repeat. Stolidly means showing confidence once again. Yes, I have 100 dresses all lined up in my drawer. Then they would let her go. And then before she would gone very far, they couldn't help bursting into shrieks and peals of laughter. Like when you listen from anyone and you could not believe that you feels that he's like saying anything which cannot be believed. So after that person would go, then you make fun of her. Phir aap log haste uspe. So that's like also like till the time Wandra used to be there, or they all used to talk her, and the moment she leave the class, leave the place, all started laughing. 100 dresses. Obviously, the only dress Wandra had was the blue one she wore every day. Like she's saying, I am having 100 dresses, but she is coming in this dress only from last so many days. And we saw her only in this dress. So why did she say she had 100 dress? If she is having 100 dress, she would be having 100 dress. She would definitely come every day with a new dress. Why she would wear the same dress again and again? How many shoes did you say you had? 60 pairs all lined up in my drawer closet. Cries of exaggerated, like oxymoron, where a lot of exaggeration is given. Politeness greeted this, all alike. Oh no, every pair is different. They used to ask, like all the shoes are like same only because you seems to be using same every day. And you are saying you are having 100 dresses and 100 shoes, which means that all those 100 would be in same color and same pattern. Then she used to say, no, all are of different colors. Oh no, every pair is different, all colors, all lined up. Peggy, who had thought up this game, and Maddie, her inseparable friend, were always the last to leave. When all girls used to leave, these two girls used to leave at last. Finally, Wanda would move up to the street, her eyes dull and her mouth closed, hitching her left shoulder every now and then in the funny way she had finishing the walk to school alone, like she used to go alone while returning from the school also. Peggy was not really cruel. She protected small children from bullies, like when other children were used to bully Wandra. Peggy was like quite helping kind of nature. She always used to protect Wandra from those small children. And she cried for hours because they used to bully her, so she cried hours and hours. If she saw an animal mistreated, if anybody had said to her, don't you think that is a cruel way to treat Wandra? Like she always used to ask other also those who used to come and bully her. So she always used to tell them, like, don't you think that whatever you are doing, this is quite cruel to treating like this to a girl? She would have been very surprised. Cruel? Why did the girl say she had 100 dresses? Like, we are not being cruel. She's only saying she is having 100 dresses. Anybody could tell that that was a lie. Why did she want to lie? If she's not having 100 dresses, then why to say? And she wasn't just an ordinary person. Else, why did she have a name like that? Like, her name is also quite uncommon. Anyway, they never made her cry. Okay? As for Maddie, this business for asking Wanda every day how many dresses and how many hats, how many pair of shoes and how many this and that she had was bothering her. Like she was, this made her bothering. Maddie was poor herself because Maddie was also like, she usually wore somebody's hand-me-down clothes, like the clothes which are already been used by others, okay, by given by someone else. Thank goodness she didn't live up on Bogans Heights or have a funny name. But main thing was that although she was a very poor girl, she was not having so much of clothes. But one thing was that she was not having normal height, short height, or she was having fair height, and her name was also quite normal. So for that only she would never been a part of being bullied. But what happened with Wandra? Wandra's name was something like uncommon, and she always used to say all these things, and she has always been seen in a single dress. So that was a quite way for funny for others also, that why she is telling lie. Sometimes when Peggy was asking Wanda those questions in that mocking, polite voice, Maddie felt embarrassed and studied the marbles in the palm of her hand, rolling them around and saying nothing herself. She used to say nothing to herself. Not that she felt sorry for Wanda. Exactly, she would never have paid any attention to Wanda if Peggy hadn't invited the dresses game. Like the dresses game was there, if she would not have been invited, she would never have said like this. But suppose Peggy and all the others started in on her next, like again, she wasn't as poor as Wanda. Like she was to a normal girl, Wanda was even poorer to Peggy. Perhaps, but she was poor. Of course, she would have more sense than to say. She said 100 dresses, still she would not like for them to begin on her. She wished Peggy would stop teasing Wanda as soon as possible. This would make her Peggy to stop her, because Maddie do not like, or in fact she did not like the Peggy to be using those teasing words for Wanda, because she was also being poor and she did not like to be treated others like Wanda like that only. So till this paragraph we complete in this lecture. In the next lecture, I will try to complete this chapter, okay? So that you will be able to understand this. And in the last lecture, we will do the question answers also, okay? So let us meet in the next lecture. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.